Hello students of 6th standard. Today we are going to start the new lesson that is nothing but the living world. So what does the living world means? Living world is a world in which there the life exists. That is called as a living world. Today we are going to see some of the pictures in your textbook. See there, first picture. That is various things in the environment. So there are various things. What does this picture tells you? See in the picture that there are some living things and there are some non-living things. Living things are the things in which there is a life, and non-living things are the things in which there is no life. So see the picture 2.1, various things in your environment. So see which are the living things: the girl, the boy, then again the hen, the dog, then again tree. These all are nothing but the, and birds, these all are nothing but the living things. And which are non-living things? Non-living things are bucket, then see ball is there, kite is there, house is there. In house there are various, you can say, things are there. The soil is there, ball is there. So these all are nothing but the non-living things. So today we are going to see how the world exists. See here, characteristics of some living things. As there are living things, they are having some characteristics. What are their characteristics? See here, there are many kinds of plants and animals around us. Whenever you see, there are various types of, you can say, plants and animals which are around us. They show some similarities and some differences. There are some similar characteristics in them, and there is some difference also in them. Yet with the help of certain features, we can tell that they are all living things. See, there are some, you can say, characteristics with which we can tell that these things are the living things. These features are not seen in the non-living things. That means living things and non-living things are quite different between, quite different between them. The living things are having life in them. They show the growth, but non-living things do not have life and they do not show growth in them. Then see, such features are said to be characteristics of the living things. Whenever you see, there are some features which are said to be characteristics of the living things. The baby grows up to become an adult person, woman or a man. Whenever you see, the baby is born, it is very, you can say, small in size. Then it grows and then the baby becomes a, you can say, adult person, or you can say a woman or a man. Then see, during the period of its growth, the baby gains height. So there is a growth of the baby. Means what? It grows in size, it grows in height, it grows in weight, it grows in strength. All these things makes the growth and development of the baby. Then see, in same manner, all animals grow in adults in certain period. There are many animals on this world, or you can say in this world, on the earth, there are various types of animals. They also grow into the adults, but into a certain period. Generally, human require 18 to 21 years for their growth. Generally, what happens? The human beings require 18 to 21 years for their growth. See in your textbook. Find out how long it takes for a young ones of a hens, cows and dogs to grow into the adults. There are also the, you can say, animals like hens, cows, dogs, and you want to observe how they grow into the adult. See next one. Try this. Tie a thread to a tip of the potted sapling. What you want to do? You want to tie a thread to the tip of the potted sapling. Potted sapling means what? A sapling which is planted in a pot. That is called as a potted sapling. Keep the thread stretched. You want to keep the thread stretched and tie it to a peg or a nail above the plant. You want to tie it to the nail above the plant. What do you observe after 10 to 15 days? You want to keep this potted plant for 10 to 15 days. Then observe this plant after 10 to 15 days. What does the plant tells you, or what tells us that the plant has grown taller? How we can understand that the plant is grown taller? In all plants, it is mainly the width and height of the stem that grows. The plant grows means what happens? The stem itself grows in height and width. So the stem grows, and then it is said that the plant is grown. As they grow, some plants develop branches with others do not. There are some plants which are developing the branches when they grow, but there are also some plants which do not give branches. Then see, though all living things grow, animals grow only for a certain period. Whenever you see that the plants grow, but there are animals which are growing for a only certain period, that means their growth period is limited. In that period only they grow. The plants, on the other hand, grow as long as they live. The plants, what they do? They grow as long as they live. The growth of the living things occurs within the body. Now, whenever you want to see the growth, you are seeing the growth of the any living thing in its body. Then see, which means that growth occurs in all parts of the, you can say, body. Food is necessary for growth. So what is necessary for growth, or what makes the growth? Whenever we eat the food, whenever we take the nutrients inside our body, then our body grows. So what is that we are going to see? See, plants, one of the important, you can say, living things on the earth. What they are doing? They are making their own food. They are making their own food. Plants produce food from water, nutrients in the soil and carbon dioxide present in the air. This process takes place in the leaves of the plants. So what happens? See there, plant prepare their food on their own. What they do? They take the carbon dioxide from the atmosphere and water and minerals from the soil, and in presence of sunlight and in presence of chlorophyll, they prepare their own food. That means what it is done? See, this all process is only brought whenever there is a, you can say, sunlight. The process of food production, this process of food production is called as a photosynthesis. During this process, plants give out oxygen. Whenever we see, plants consume carbon dioxide, but they give out oxygen. Then see, plants appear mainly green in color due to the chlorophyll in them. Plants appear green in color mainly because they are having a chlorophyll in them. Animals, however, do not have chlorophyll in them. Animals do not appear green in color, so they don't have a chlorophyll in them. They do not produce their own food. They do not prepare their own food. They go in search of a food, or they depend on others for the, you can say, food. Animals such as goat, sheep, horses, they eat grass. And wild animals like tiger and lions, they need their, you can say, food, or they eat their food by hunting the animals which live on the plants. Then see here, next point, that is nothing but respiration. So you have to hold your hand in front of your nose, or you want to keep your hand on your chest. What do you feel? See there, if there is a sleeping dog, what movement of its belly do you see? So see, always you see that whenever we respire, our lungs move up and down. So living things, there are living things which need oxygen in order to live. Inhaling oxygen and exhaling the carbon dioxide, this is done in the body, and that is inhaling and exhaling together, we call it as a respiration. Animals like, you can say, fish or snake or mouse, they have, you can say, specific organs for their respiration. On other hands, plants respire by means of microscopic pores on the stems and the leaves. So there are, you can say, very minute pores on the leaf, and through this only the plants respire. But we people, that is man on or some animals, what they do, they respire with their lungs. But there are some animals which respire with the, you can say, gills. For example, the fish, they are having the respiratory organs as gills. We are, you can say, respiring the oxygen and carbon dioxide with the help of the lungs and nose. We are having the special respiratory system. But plants are not having the special respiratory system. They are having a, you can say, tiny pores on the leaves, which are called as a stomata. And through these pores only they do, or they respire. Then see next one, excretion. Excretion means what? To give out the unwanted substances which are not useful for the body. Such substances are given out of the body. This is called as the excretion. They may be in the form of the urine, or may be in the form of the excreta. Excreta is given through, you can say, anus, and urine is given out through the urinary system. Then see, waste substances are formed during many processes that takes place in the bodies of the animals. They are called as a excreta. So there are various substances which are formed in the body. They are called as a, you can say, excreta. And the process of eliminating this from the body is called as a excretion. Animals have specific organs for the excretion. Animals are having a specific, you can say, organs for excretion. But plants do not have the specific excretory system. Then see, plants too excrete. Plants also excrete. Some plants shed their leaves. Some plants shed their leaves in the specific season. Waste substances stored in the leaves of the plants are shed through the, you can say, leaves.